In this video, I'm going to show you guys how to make a small brig in Minecraft. Now, if you guys are new to the channel at all, we do a lot of time lapses and tutorials just like this one, so make sure to hit that subscribe button. Also guys, if you want more videos like this one, I'll leave a link in the card above, as well as in the description to a full playlist that you guys can check out. Anyway, let's get into building. Alright, so here we are on my flat tutorial world, and here is the build out of water. So in terms of its dimensions, this one is 28 blocks long, 11 blocks wide, and 25 blocks high. If you guys are going to be building this one in the water, you're going to be 2 blocks down. That means your water is going to be at this level. You'll have a block, and you have 1 block down from there, and this is the same level as number 1. Okay, nice and simple from that point. If you guys are going to be building this one docked, feel free to make yourself a nice rectangle. That will then figure out, you know, where everything is. Of course, we're just almost a couple blocks from the back of this build that become apparent as we start building. Materials that you're going to need are smooth quartz slab, stair, block, and also white concrete. Although I forgot to do the variation on this one, we will be doing it on the one that we're tutorialing today. We're also going to need spruce planks, spruce stair, and jungle fence, just to get us started. So for layer number one, what we're going to do is, where we're in the middle of this box, you're going to come forwards by 3 blocks. So 1, 2, 3, that's where your starting block is going to be. And that's going to be a spruce planks block. Place another block on top of that one. Then we're going to have a spruce stair block. And then 2 fence pieces of your jungle fence right there like that. We can now get rid of those 3 blocks. That's the only reason that I did those, is so we can get rid of them. Nice and easy now. Now what we're going to do is we're going to have just smooth quartz blocks. And we're going to have 3 of those. 1, 2, and 3. Just at the back of that. On either side of this, we'll have a smooth quartz slab. We'll do the other side in a bit. We'll have a smooth quartz slab there like that. We're then going to have 2 blocks going forward, so 1 and 2. And just on this block here, we're going to have a slab. Then we're going to add another slab on the side of that one, coming forwards with that one, should I say. Then we can have 3 smooth quartz stairs, 1, 2, and 3 like that. Then we're going to have a slab coming forwards. On the back or the side kind of parts of this, we're going to have a block. Then we're going to have another block coming forwards like this with a slab on the front of that one. Then what we're going to do is right on the back of this now, we're going to have a block again just to block up that slab gap that we got. Come forwards with a block and then we're going to have another slab. So that is what you end up getting. Now for the other side, we'll do the same thing. So we get a slab first. 2 blocks behind, 1 and 2. Gonna have a slab on the side of that one. Slab coming backwards, or actually technically forwards. And then 3 upside down stairs, 1, 2, and 3. Then we're gonna have a slab on the side of that one. Behind that slab, we're gonna have a block, then another block coming forwards. And then where we've got this gap, we're gonna whack in a slab like that. Now what we can do is we can fill this level up all with your smooth quartz like that. But that is it guys for layer number one. And now for layer number two, what we're going to do is just place a block directly on top of the last layer here. Then we're going to have an upside down smooth quartz stair coming forwards from that. We're going to have a stair on the side of this one. Don't know why I always do this. Whenever I do like this layer, I always put the stairs either side, but who knows. Stair there. Add 2 blocks behind that one, 1 and 2. Then we're going to have a slab on the side of that one. Then we're going to have 8 blocks behind, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, like that. We're now going to have a slab coming across, out from the back of that one there. Then behind this, where we've got this little gap in here, we're going to have a block, then 1 more block coming out. And then a slab here like that. And in this gap, we're just going to have a block of your quartz just to finish that one up. So let's get around to the other side now. So behind that stair, we're going to have 2 blocks, 1 and 2. Then a slab on the side of that one. Then 8 blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Then what we're going to do on the end of this one is have a slab. On the inside there, we're going to have a block and another block coming forwards. And then we're going to have another slab right in the middle of that one there, like that. But that is it, guys, for... Actually, let's do another bit very, very quickly. It'll get us get started anyway. Grab yourself a stripped spruce wood, and then what we're going to do is right here. That's where you're going to have your first stripped spruce wood. That'll be the first of the two masts. And at the back, what we're going to do is where we go to here, go forwards by one, and that's where your mast is going to be. So you end up with this really small space to kind of walk around, but that's absolutely fine. So plonk that in there. Now we're going to level number 3. And now for layer number 3, what you guys are going to do is on the front here, place a block directly on top of the last layer. Then you're going to come forwards with an upside down smooth quartz stair. On the side of this, you're going to have a smooth quartz stair as well. And then we're going to have two blocks behind, one and two, one and two. Now guys, grab yourself a coloured block. It's up to you what you want to use. I use the nice mangrove that we've got in here, but you could use anything else. All you're really going to need to do is find yourself a nice stairs block and, well, go with that, roll with that. Could be warped, could be anything else, could be normal wood, who knows, whatever you want. Anyway, what we're going to do here is we're going to have an upside down stair on the side of that one, so your mangrove stair in this case. Then we're going to have 11 blocks behind that of your colour. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. Then we're going to have a slab on the end of that one. Then what we're going to do is we're going to switch back over to your white block of smooth quartz. Going to place a block on the last layer here, like that. Then we're going to have an upside down stair. Then right where we got the rudder, place just a normal block. And then on the other side, of course, upside down stair, normal block there, like that. Let's do the same on the other side now. So we get that upside down mangrove stair first. 11 blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Then we get a slab like that. Now what we can finally do is with our white concrete, every so often just replace one of the blocks with white concrete to give it a little bit of a texture to the whole thing, okay? Whoops, try not to get them in the same place on either side, but if you do, does it matter? No, of course not. So there we go, we'll get this in here. Yeah, that'll do for the time being, I think. There we go, look at that, nice. Nice bit of variation. Then the only other thing we need to do, guys, is with your oak slab, we're going to have an oak slab right on the front here. Just on the side of those two, like that. Anyway, let's get on to the next layer. And now for layer number 4, what we're going to do is right on the front here, place a block of your coloured block just on the top of this one here. Then we're going to have an upside down stair coming forwards from that, and an upside down stair on either side of that as well. We're now going to have two plank blocks behind this, like that. And then we're going to switch over to dark oak stairs. So we're actually going to have an upside down dark oak stair here, like that, just on top of that oak slab. And behind that stair, you're going to have 11 blocks of dark oak planks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Then what we'll do is we're going to switch over to our coloured block again, in this case, mangrove. And we're going to have two blocks of mangrove planks just on top of that last level. Then, with your mangrove stairs, we're going to have an upside down stair on the side here, like that. Coming around the back, we're going to have three upside down stairs going across the back, with a mangrove trapdoor just in between those. Now, whatever you've got elsewhere, it's just to kind of go on top of this block so that block doesn't just kind of stick out. Just gives it a little bit of a cap underneath it. Feel free to use whatever you guys want to for that. That's gone to the other side now, so we get that upside down dark oak stair here. 11 blocks of dark oak planks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. We're going to get two blocks of mangrove, 1 and 2. Then an upside down stair just on the side of that one, like that, with a mangrove trapdoor right on the end of that block there. Now if we come back to the front again, we're going to have our oak slab. And we're going to have an oak slab here and then here, just moving our way up. Where we've got that upside down dark oak stair, we're going to have an acacia fence. Then behind that, we're going to have an oak slab on the upper piece, just there like that. We're going to leave a block gap. Then we're going to have two spruce slabs in there like that. That's going to be for the shrouds. So I'll do the same on the other side now. So first with our oak slab, lower there, upper there. Acacia fence time right next to that stair, like that. Then behind this, we're going to have an oak slab. Leave a gap. Two spruce slabs behind that, there, like that. And on the back right here, where we've got the dark oak level, we're going to have two slabs there right on the side. Okay. And now with your stripped spruce wood, build that up. I have another two on top of that. With your oak slabs, what we're going to do is we're going to have one slab here, and then we're going to have, I believe it's five. One, two, three, four, and five. Yeah, five on the side there, like that. Five on the side there, like that as well. And guys, that is it for layer number four. All right, and now for layer number five, what we're going to do, guys, is you're going to need to grab yourself some more of your dark oak stuff. So grab yourself a slab, where you already got a stair and also a block. We're also going to need an oak slab, acacia fence, spruce fence gate, crimson high, whatever. And also a glass pane, and even a jungle trapdoor. We'll need some other stuff. I have no idea how to pronounce that, but we're going to use that block. So first things first, we're going to place a block of dark oak planks right on the front here. Then the next one, we're going to be directly on top as well with just a block of dark oak planks. Then we're going to have a dark oak stair like that. Dark oak stair going that way as well. Now we're going to have an upside down dark oak stair. And then another upside down dark oak stair there like that. Now I'll do the same on the other side. So you get a block here, dark oak stair, dark oak stair, upside down dark oak stair, upside down dark oak stair like that. Then with our spruce fence gate, we're going to have four of these going across. One, two, three, and four. So one, two, three, and four like that. Back to our stairs. We have an upside down dark oak stair on the back of that one. And then another dark oak stair like that. Then what we're going to do is we're going to have a normal dark oak stair right here. Then on the side right over here, we're going to have a dark oak stair going this way. We're going to have one there to pull it around. Then we're going to have a block. Then the crimson hyphae thing. Block that down there. Then a glass pane. Then a crimson block. Glass pane right there. Whoops. Then a crimson block. Glass pane, crimson block, glass pane, crimson block. So you can get that kind of back bit there like that. Then what we're going to do with the jungle trapdoor is whack that onto those glass panes just to give it a little bit of a kind of just a bit of detail on the back, really. It's up to you if you want to leave it blank or use another trapdoor. Feel free to go for that, no problem at all. Now what we can do is we can grab ourselves a warped fence. And wherever we got those crimson blocks, whack a warped fence on. Like that. And this is just to give it a little bit of, just some highlights, really, to have a different colour compared to these kind of reddy, pinky colours, or purpley colours, just to give it something a little bit different. So you just whack those on there like that. Right, we better do the other side now. So what we'll do with our dark oak stair is have an upside down dark oak stair there, and then another dark oak stair like that. We get a dark oak stair going that way, dark oak stair going that way. Then the next one is going to be sideways, so it'll wrap that one around, okay? So you get the illusion of like a slab being here. That's the idea with that thing. And then what we do is we've got a dark oak block right in there like that. And now what we'll end up doing is we actually can grab ourselves a composter. So we're going to just plonk a composter onto each of those, onto the masts. There we go, get there eventually with my words. And we're going to grab a couple extra blocks now, so we can just clear down a couple of these. Actually, we could do with that acacia fence. Do grab that acacia fence, we're going to need it in a sec. But we are going to need a ladder, a spruce trapdoor, and an oak trapdoor. So I ended up putting the entrance into the hold on my one on the frontmost mast. It's up to you guys, you can do it on the backmost mast, or both, whatever you want. So I just put in two ladders on here, so that if you're wandering around this bit, you don't kind of get caught or anything like that. But it's up to you guys what you want to do. Then we're going to have a spruce trapdoor just there. Now if we build four blocks, and plonk those in, and then put down oak trapdoors. And that just means when we open the hold up, we can just have it like that and then be able to get into it and pull stuff out. That's the idea anyway. Though this would more than likely be some sort of netting kind of material. So you just be able to undo the kind of ropey netty stuff. So not too bad there. Right, so next come to the front with your oak slab. And what we're going to do is where we've got that fence there, we're going to plonk a slab on top. We're then going to have an upper slab right here. Then we're going to have an acacia fence on the side of that. Lower slab right in there. And we're going to need an oak stair. So we're going to have an upside down oak stair on the front there like that. So the same on the other side. Slab on top of that last one here. One more going up. An acacia fence next. A lower slab there. And we've already got that stair in place like that. Okay, and then with your oak slab, what we're going to do is right where we've got the kind of like front part, we're just going to do the next part of the deck. So we get a lower slab right here. We get another layer of lower slabs across here. Then we just get, well, we've got the red block showing through. Knock one in there on either side. And then grab yourself a spruce slab. And we're going to have a spruce slab here and a spruce slab here like that. That's going to be part of the bow sprit, all right? So that's what that's going to be about. For the back now, what we're going to do as well, of course, going to be building it up. So grab yourself your oak slab. And what we're going to do here is going to have two going across there, like that, to cover up that little gap there. We're going to have one at the back. And then next, we're going to be building up to the upper slab. So we've got an upper slab here. This is going to go around that little slab there. So you get a little U going around like that. Then we're going to add one more in the middle as well, just like that. But that's it, guys, for layer number 5. Okay, now for layer number 6. What we're going to do, guys, is we're going to start on the front first. And where we've got this dark oak stairs here, we're going to go to the second one right here. So the one that's closest to the front. Place a slab on top of that one. Then you're going to have a slab coming forwards like that. Next bit over here, we're going to have a slab directly on top of the last layer here. So where we've got that little stair in there. It gives the illusion of an upside down stair going on here, which I quite like doing that kind of stuff, as you guys have probably noticed. And we'll do the same on the other side as well. So we get a slab there and a slab there like that. Although you don't get to see some of these, it does give good patterns in the inside of those, even though it doesn't give a big air gap. At the front now, we're going to have another slab here and then another slab going up. So you end up with just slabs moving upwards with the bowsprit. And then what we're going to do is with our dark oak planks is we're going to plonk a plank directly on top of this one right here. Then with our oak slab, we're going to have an oak slab on the side of that one on top of that acacia fence. Then we're going to have one on the forward front of that one. Then we're going to have one coming all the way to the front right there. So the same on the other side, one on top of that acacia fence. One right next to this kind of block right there. And then you've already got the one in the middle like that. But that then finishes up the beak and also the kind of like front part of the ship. So now if we move on to the back section, what we're going to do here is again, grab yourself your dark oak slabs. And where we've got these ones here, these two, we're going to put a slab on top of that one, slab on top of that one like that. Then we're going to have an upside down stair here. Whoops, upside down stair here like that. Another upside down stair there like that. Same on the other side as well. So we get slab, slab, stair, and stair. And it's all to do with this, just creating these like little gaps that are moving up quite gently. That's the whole plan with that whole section like that. Then what we're going to do is we're going to have a normal stair on top of the crimson hyperfey thingamajigger. Then we can have an upside down stair over the window. On the side of this one, a normal stair. Then we're going to have an upside down stair here like that. Then we're going to have a slab, and then the same again on the other side. So we get an upside down stair over the window, normal stair going across this way on top of the crimson hyperfey thing. Then on top of this one is a normal stair going this way and upside down over the window like that. Quite complicated, all right? So don't worry if you're getting a little bit stuck. Then with our oak slabs now, what we can do is we can have this, whoops, not there, have this on the lower slab here like that, just to finish that bit up. Now grab yourself a grindstone, and this is where I ended up putting the wheel for mine, right in this place. It just felt kind of like natural. You could of course have it there, but then it looks, well, feels a bit small, so that's where I went with mine. You can at least step behind the wheel. Feels quite like a good point to have it in there. Grab yourself a crimson slab now, and we're just going to go over these little window bits. We're just going to do slab, slab, slab like that. Slab, 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 slab like that. Same on the sides as well, like that. And then that all is looking pretty good. But that is it, guys, for layer number 6, I want to say. And now what we're going to do, guys, is we're going to finish up the hull. So this is going to be layers 7 to 8. We don't need to do anything on the front at all. We're all done with that section. So it's just around to the back part of it. What we're going to do, guys, is where we've got this kind of a little stair coming in here, we're going to put a slab on top of that. Have a slab going backwards. We're not going to have a slab here, but we are going to have one on top of this level here. And we're also going to have one going over the top. So slab there like that. And then we're going to have two slabs in there, like that. Right, so now what we're going to do is with our spruce trapdoor, we're going to have three spruce trapdoors coming out. One underneath here, just to give it a little bit more kind of support. And then within the lantern, we're just going to have that lantern on there. And feel free, if you want to, guys, to grab yourself your chain. And it's up to you, whatever you want, really. You can have this where it's hanging down. And feel free to make that hang down as much as you want, really. It's up to you what you think looks best for that kind of part of it, really. You know, totally cool. Now, the only other thing we're going to do on this level, or layer even, is we're going to just finish up the bowsprit. So this, we've already done 4 of these going up. We're going to be 11 in total. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whoops, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. I'm just going to knock out these ones here, because we're going to just have it with single slabs. It's just that if you place it like that, it gives you the fastest and best way to do that. But there we go, guys. We're now done with the hull of the ship, so we'll get on to the masts, sails, shrouds, and all of that stuff. Alright, so let's get on to the masts. So what we're going to need is some stripped spruce wood, a composter, spruce trapdoor, granite wall, spruce fence, barrel, spruce stairs, spruce slab, and also oak fence. That's going to be your kind of like materials list for this section. What we're going to do then is we're going to do the front one first. Going to build up with 7 blocks on top of your composter. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then with the composters, we're going to have 2 high. And we're going to go forwards with 2. So you end up with this 2x2 block like this. Then on top of the front one, we're going to go up with 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. On top of this, place a granite wall. And then 2 spruce fences. Feel free to put flags on as well, guys. Totally up to you. Also, over this, the compost now, just to block that up, put a spruce trapdoor on top, like that. Then what we're going to do is, with our barrel now, we're going to have a barrel sideways, just under. So one underneath this, I'll leave a block gap right here, have your barrel there. And they're going to have a stripped spruce wood coming out, either side of that. And then depending on which way your sails are turning, mine always just seem to turn this way. Apparently the wind always flows the same way in all of my worlds. But that's absolutely fine. Yeah, we're going to have it going that way. So in order to do that, we're going to have 3 going across here. And then we get 3 going across the other way. So you end up with this nice little diagonal thing. So you've got the mast moving forwards a bit and also these going across like that. Then what we're going to do is we're going to leave 2 from the top here and then have a barrel on the side. And we're going to do the same thing, so 1 on each side of that barrel. Then we get 3, and then we get another 3. Like that, okay? So it's just coming off of the front of that one. For the backmost mast now, we're going to go up with 8 first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Again, we're going to have 2 composters and then 2 coming forwards as well. Block up that one right at the back. Then we're going to add 7 on top. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Then a granite wall, and then 2 fences. Now with this one, we've got a slightly different sail plan. So we've got this kind of, whatever it's called, the kind of like a schooner type sail thing. I've totally forgotten all the terms, but I think it's called a spanker or something like that. It's got a really weird name. But we've got one of those, and also a kind of boxed rig, kind of square rigged one at the top. So 2 blocks down again, so, or leave 2 blocks, shall I say. then have this one here. I'm going to do the same thing as these ones where we've got sets of three. So get three there, there, three there, like that. And then for this, the spanker gonna sail, we're gonna have a stair right on the side of this one, just starting on that back corner. We're gonna go forwards, and then we're gonna go forwards again, and then again, okay? So we get four, set of four there, and then going back, gonna be at an angle. So we just have one going out. And we're gonna have another set of four. Like that, so you end up getting four and then four, but just offset by one. And then what we're gonna do is with your spruce slab, right down here, we're gonna be two up, and then on the upper piece here, we're gonna place a slab, okay? And then have two coming forwards. Then we're gonna go out and up by one slab to there. And that's gonna be a three. And then we're gonna do the same again. Whoops, like that there, okay? And now what we can do is we can start to connect these up, all right? So we're going to have an oak fence right here on the second to last part of your bowsprit. Then step back and up and up, back and up and back and up and back and up. And you just keep doing that motion until you get to the end, which is there. There we go. It's right there on top of the mast. Then it's up to you guys if you want to like kind of make this a lot less thick, which is what I'm going to do on mine, so I just take out the bottom one like that, and then that will give you just some nice lines like that. Between the two masts, we're going to go 1, 2, 3, and 4, then down 2 and 3 to connect those two together like that. There is another place that I need to connect them together, which is just on the lowest one. Okay, good. So here we're going to go 1, 2, 3, then down 2 and 3, whoop, and 2 and 3 like that to join it. So we've got those two connections there and there. All right. Then next, what we're going to do is we're going to connect this bit with this bit down here. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3 with our fence. Then we're going to go back with 1, 2, and 3. Then we're going to come towards this block here, out with 1, 2, 3, and then we're going to go back to 3 and 4, okay? So I know it's a bit weird, but it's to try and get this kind of nice shape that we can then use later on. We're now going to build a little crow's nest. So on the backmost mast, there's only one of these on this, but you could if you wanted to. There's no reason why you can't whack it onto this one. I mean, the only thing you've got to be aware of is this kind of gets in the way of a ladder going up. Oh, and in fact, actually, we need to grab ourselves a nice ladder, don't we? There we go. It's a block I forgot about. But for me, I just put it on the back. So where we've got the mast kind of meeting the back here, we're going to have a stair. Then we're going to have a stair that then wraps around at the back there. Stair there, wraps around the back, and then has a slab right at the back of that one. That will give us a block gap to get a ladder down to there. So you can then at least climb up this one. Yes, when you get to this bit, you have to jump to get up, but that's absolutely fine, I think. That'll get you up to the top of this one. Then with your oak fence, you can have just oak fence pieces on each of those just to make it, it doesn't make it safe, but you know what I mean, makes it a little bit safer, especially when I can't even get onto it, but yeah, it does make it a little bit safer if you're against these bits, but obviously the diagonal part of it is very, well, very precarious. But there we go, guys, that is then all of the masts all done, so we'll now get on to the sails section. Okay, so now we're going to get on to the sails. So we'll do a tied up version first, because it's the easiest one. We're going to do... Oh, and also I should say, guys, if you want to use any other blocks, feel free to do so. I usually use white wool still for the sails. I don't mind the blockiness look of it, but you could if you want to use the smooth quartz slabs and stairs. It's just a lot more complicated and you're going to spend a lot more time on it. But it's totally up to you guys what you want to do. So yeah, what we're going to do is we're going to come forwards from this mast, and we're just going to come forwards with one block like this, and come forwards like that. And then what we can start doing is we can start pushing back some blocks. We also want to have a little bit of a bunch up kind of in the middle. So you might do something like that in order to make it look tied up. So the idea being that, you know, the whole sail is kind of, you know, literally wrapped all the way up. But then you might have some ties, you know, right going across these bits, and a little bit in the middle is kind of drooping around. That's the kind of idea behind that. And you can do that on all of the other ones as well. It's exactly the same. For this one, if you're going to do the tied up version, you just place a block on each of these like that, and then do a similar thing where you end up having a bunched up kind of middle. Perhaps like that. Really, really simple. I mean, there's not too much to it, really. But, of course, we are going to be doing the full sails. So, let's get on to that. Now, what we do for this is we're going to do them very organically. That means that yours is going to be different to mine. Even mine is going to be different to mine, all right? They always turn out different. I don't know why. Sometimes they're better, sometimes they're worse. It doesn't really matter too much. Because the overall build, you'll then be able to see, oh yeah, there's sails there, and that's fine. So we're going to do the same thing as we did with the tied up version. We're going to bring these out by one block, like this, right? Then we're going to come forward, so we're going to do, let's do a two, okay? So we're going to have two going down. We just follow the same pattern as we've already got. So we've got one, two, and then let's see what else we've got. We've got, we could do a two, and then we could do a one. Yeah, let's do that. We'll do a two and a one to go into here. And this might be different than what I did. It might be the same as what I did. I have a tendency to, with the kind of base of it, to usually be roughly the same, but not always, as I found in these tutorials. But there we go. You end up with this like really squared version of things, okay? And it doesn't look great at the minute, but that's fine. We're also going to do this the same with the bottom one as well. So we get this here. So just do a one. So always start with a one. Then we're going to do a two, and then we're going to do a maybe we'll do a one one and then a two. I think. Because of where we're at, and then we would do a 1 if we've got the space, which we will do on some of these sides down there, okay? So that's what we're going to do, 1, 1, 2. I think this is probably going to be different to what I did before, but that's fine, like I said. So we're going to get that there, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, and then that 1, which will just bring us in down the bottom. So that's the kind of thing that you'll end up getting, okay? And you could do this, you know, you could do that where you have a 1 there and you can have a 2 in the middle instead if you wanted to. Depends on what you think looks best. You can do the same on the back here. We're just doing all the base sails for the time being. Because this will get us working quite quickly. I'm going to do a 2 on that one there. So we've got a 1, a 2. Give a 2 a go. Yeah, we're going to give a 2 a go as well. Try and get 3s in usually, but this is a very small brig, so don't think we're going to be able to, and then we'll pull it in with one, okay? And that pulling it in with one is quite important. That will really help. If you hit a fence like I have, don't worry about it. Just literally ignore it. Sounds really weird, but that is what we'll do. All right, so now for shaping this, okay? We're also going to grab a oak fence as well. We'll plonk those in as we go. So what we're going to do to shape it? Well, this looks really boring, really, really square and horrible. So what you want to do is you want to find these horrible corners like this, and if you knock that one out and then pull it forwards, you'll notice it makes it look better, and we can then do similar things down here, like here, maybe pull this one forwards, maybe this one's going to go back, you know, you can end up doing these kind of things, and you can start to see that the shape is starting to take place. We're now starting to get a little bit more of a real shape to the thing, and you're literally just moving blocks forwards or back off of that frame. There we go, so we might do that then. There we go, that looks a lot better. Push this one forwards, okay? And you'll end up with something like that really quite easily. Then what we want to do is add a little bit on the end, so we just get these kind of like wispy bits that are kind of just sticking out. And it just helps make the sail look like the right shape. Sometimes you can go back with like two. And what you want to try and do is then pinch those corners a little bit. So you might have this one back here, which means this one goes back, okay? And then you do the same down the bottom as well. So you might have this here. And to go to there, yeah, let's go right to there. There we go. So that then ends up looking quite good. And you do the same, of course, on the other side as well. So we might end up with pushing these back quite a bit. Perhaps like that. There we go. Now what I want you guys to do is cut out about 3 blocks, maybe even 4 blocks from the middle. And also you can do the same underneath here as well if you want to. Or, so I didn't do it on mine, but instead what I did is I had an extra block going down. We'll see what this one looks like, and then we'll come back to that one to see what we want to do with that. So same again here, guys. So we end up doing that kind of like moving blocks around. So we're just going to start with cutting out 3 in the middle there like that. Let's move that one to there, perhaps. This one might be moved back like that. This one might be moved back, and then this one goes down. And this goes down. Okay. And even out as well. I'm going to do it out. There we go. That's better. So, you know, you keep on tweaking is basically the main thing with this one. So I'm going to just push these all back. I'm actually going to push all of that section back to get that to there. And then, like that, finally cut that corner into there. There we go. And you can see what happened with that one, how we've got that cut underneath. And although we started really square and we had just two blobs, that's actually given it quite a lot of shape. So we might actually do the same thing here now that we've not gone up too high. Didn't actually go out with that one, but that's fine. So we might go to like there. I'm going to cut a couple blocks into this one, I think. So I think it'll make it look better. Yeah, it does make it look better. So there we go. We got those two sails done. Now the next one, same technique. So you just move some of them forwards, cut out some in the middle, get some down here. This is what I was saying about this bit. You might have this bit coming forwards now. So you then don't need to worry about that. Then we're going to have this all kind of being pushed back a bit. Like that. I'll do the same kind of stuff over here. Yeah, go there. Why not? Let's go to that point. Okay. I'll get there eventually. There we go. Cut that one into there. And let's do pushing this forwards. I want to create a little bit more gap just for that to have a block there, really. But there we go. That looks pretty good, actually. So we can now just have this bit go down a little bit more. So we've got a weird thing going on there. Let's move that forwards then. And let's move that one down as well. And this is where it gets really difficult to be able to see. But this is what I'm saying. It doesn't really matter too much when you've got all the sails in. Even if you've done one that's not the best in the world, it's absolutely fine. Nobody's going to notice. So there we go. We've got that one all done now. So let's do this back one, okay? So it's going to be a slightly different sail. Now that we've done the three square ones, we'll do this one. So for this one, follow the shape is the main thing, which is, you know, where you've got this fence, you can follow that shape. Bring this forwards, maybe. Have the couple down here. Now I need to join between this point and this point, which is quite easy for us. We can just go to there. Now, what we've got is we've got bits that are out and bits that are back. So we can then, you know, fill in bits down here, but we need to get down to this point, okay? So we might do something like that. With this one, push this one back. Like that. So we're trying to get this nice smooth kind of thing going on. And it's the same here as well. We can then have this coming forwards. Like that there. And now I can see a nice big bit here where we've got a really thin one there, but we can actually then knock these out. Move that forwards, maybe even move this forwards as well down here, and even that one down there. Like that. That also gives us more space for this one then. Just to get into there. Maybe we knock that one back. And then maybe we cut out some blocks in here. Just to move that out as well. And just to give it a little bit more shape, knock that one out. It'll suddenly make it look better. It's really weird. Sometimes you get this stuff where you have an extra block there. And it just makes it look really blocky and like it ends. And as soon as you do that, it then looks a lot better. So I know these ones are a little bit weird and you can keep on tweaking them for quite a while. I mean, that's what I ended up with on this one and this one. Totally different, really. So this one actually goes out like more on this side of it, but then curls in more on that bit. Whereas this one seems to be more bunched down the bottom, a little bit more anyway. It's not majorly different, actually. Not huge, but you know, that's the thing. Variation is key. Right, so now we're going to do the jib. Right, so for the jib, we're going to end up smashing into these sails, just so you know. It's going to happen. Don't worry about it. So what we'll do is we'll place a block just underneath these fences first. And I'm going to start away from these sails to make it easy. Then add just an extra block in between each of those ones. And then we're going to go out. Might have a block going out to like that. And then we're going to go out again, but this time diagonal from this one. Okay, and then maybe we start to pull ourselves in. Okay, so we need to pull ourselves into like a point like that. But we might end up having like a block down there, maybe a block down there, and then to give it a good bit of shape, maybe have a couple there. So we end up with this kind of a pattern going on. So with that one, I'm going to knock that one down, in fact. I think, yep, down. Can we have it there as well? I don't know. Maybe even have it out as well. There we go, that looks better, doesn't it? That's better. So you end up with this nice little triangular shape here with a little bit of a cut out there. And there's my other one, totally different. Actually, that one doesn't look very good. This one looks better. But guys, that is it for the sails. They are one of the things that you get used to. Oh, I say it's that's it. Before we finish up, oak fence the back of it. Connect your sails on somehow, you know, have them anchored. And I just whack them in whenever I can see the wall really next to it. I don't bother with any of these middle bits. There's no point. But whack it in there. And don't worry about this one. It just doesn't quite work with that one. So now, guys, let's get onto the shrouds. And now onto the shrouds. Grab yourself some birch fence. That's going to get us started. We're going to start on the left-hand side of the ship because we've got our sails angled this way. It's just a lot easier. Whereas we tend to find we clash on this side. So we get a nice clean run for this side. Sometimes clash with the mast on that side, with the sail on that side, and that's fine. Basically, you just ignore the shroud parts of it and keep your sails. So what we're going to do first is where we've got these spruce slabs, we're going to put on two on top of that one, another two on top of that, and another one. So we've got three high like that one. Add another two onto the back. Then we're going to build up another two on top of that. Then we're going to have one more going forwards from that. So you end up with a three going across with that section. Add another two on top of that. One and two and one and two. Not on the back one though. So it's just these front two like that. Join two on the back of that. Two going up. And make that two like double up that section that you've got there. Then we're going to come forwards with one which will go on top of your mast. Then we're going to have an additional three on top. One, two, and three. One, two, and three. So you get that with the twos as well. And then what we do is we go one, two, and three with just a single at the end to get to the topmost mast. So that is the kind of thing that you end up with. If you guys get something different, it doesn't matter. It's honestly, it's just a rough way to get some rope from there to there. That's the main thing. So on the other side, it's the same thing, so we'll see how it goes. We're going to go one, two, three to get us started. Add some fences on the back. Then what we're going to do is we're going to have another layer on top of those two, but then come forwards with one extra one like that. Add another two on top, and then another two on that one, but not on the back. You'll notice that this now connects into the back of the mast. This is what I'm saying. It starts to clash, but it's fine. As long as I remember what I'm actually doing. Then what we're going to do is we're going to add two on the back, like that, there we go. And then we're going to add another two layers on top of that. And then where we've got the mast, we're going to have one coming forwards, just like that. Then we have three on top, one, two, three, one, two, three, but not on the last one there because we're moving forwards. Then we're going to have three singles on there to get to this mast, there we go. But like I said, it will clash, it's fine. If it clashes with your sail, no worries. Ignore these blocks. That's basically the main rule about this stuff is ignore, like keep these and ignore these, all right? It will look better. If you start cutting out your sail, it starts to look weird to have shrouds in there. For the back now, what we're going to do is we're going to have four on the back of these. So one, two, three, and four. And they are doubled as well, as you would expect. Then we're going to have two connected on the back of that one. Two on top of those two. All right. One coming forwards. And then we're going to add another three on top of just the front two. So one, two, three. Connect onto the back. One and two. Come forwards with one. Then what you're going to do is you're going to have three going up. One, two, three. One, two, and three. Then we're going to have four singles, one, two, three, and four, which will bring you to this point. Now, the other side, you're going to fail miserably, but that's fine. So we're going to go one, two, three, four, and then we can't connect anymore, and that's it. You can't do anymore. What you can do, however, is you can have your singles down here, and you've got the double there, so you can actually end up having another one down there as well. But that's literally it. You could, if you really wanted to, have the bits that you can see in here. You could do this kind of stuff. We have that, and then you might have like one there, But I find that just ends up looking really messy and it looks like you're really confused. So I tend not to do that. But anyway, guys, that is it for this tutorial. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed it. If you guys have got any interior design plans as well, because I haven't done one for this one, then make sure to post that to me on my Discord channel and whack it into the medieval chat that we've actually got there. You know, post some pictures. It'd be really cool to see. And if you guys have a video or anything like that that you want to share on there, whack that in the promotion channel. That'd be cool as well. I'm sure people will be interested to see what you've done with it. But hopefully you guys have enjoyed this video. If you have, make sure to comment, like, and subscribe. And as always, guys, I'll see you on the next one.